So in our battle of attrition tonight, we have one last match for Peter. We're going to have Neil Yakura come out again and have him, well, let's welcome him to the court. Come on, Neil. Silent auction going on outside on the table. So make sure you get a chance to bid on the items that we've got out here. Lots of good items. This is the last singles match of the night. Which is unfortunate because it's been a great evening in badminton. Let's hear it for all the contestants tonight, in particular here for Neil and Peter. Once again, I want to thank everyone here for coming and for Clear Wine for putting this on. I want to let everyone know that there's a Clear Wine in Orlando, and it's about 28 degrees there. You can come down to Clear Wine Orlando and down and play with Kevin, Katie, me.
Thank you. 3.
Thank you.
Ha ha ha! point dead.
Go, Vito!
Come back!
Come on, Vito!
Come on, guys.
Saw that tonight. Let's hear it for Peter Gabe. And let's hear it also for Neil Yacora, who put on an excellent show for us. Neil, I'm going to guess ahead of time that your comment about this theme was exhausting.
Take your number.
Yeah.
That pretty much sums it up, yes. Now, we threw the best we could throw at Peter tonight, and you heard a number of the players allude to, and even the people in the audience say, oh, trick shot. We're going to get Peter to show us some of those quotation marks trick shots, but I think the important thing for everyone to understand what we call a trick shot for Peter is part of the game is deception. And because of Peter's incredible footwork on the court and his ability to get to these shots and control the racket head, he's able to deceive. Other people call it a trick shot. For most part, it's part of the strategic part of the game. It's part of deception. Yeah. Let's hear it for Thomas, who's going to help him.
Okay. Yeah, everyone can hear me. Perfect. The thing about trick shots is actually strange because these are the strokes that you can practice more than any other stroke. And in a match, you never use them more than once. So it's kind of strange, but that one feeling when the other opponent are just going the other way, the other direction, and you put it in the corner, that's just an amazing feeling. So that keeps you practicing. It may not be that easy for everyone to see what's going on, but I'll just try if you want. This one is a flick shot from this side. Actually, this shot is I take an inspiration from an Indonesian guy called Hendrawan, which many of you may know him. I know him from the 2001 final. Not a good memory. No. He's a great player, and he is good at deceptive shots, and I kind of took some inspiration. He does it a bit in another way, but so this is kind of bad. Just give me a shovel. Oh, it's okay. I don't mind. This is kind of a two-part movement. So I have to get as close to the shuttle as possible, then drag my racket down and hit. So this goes very fast. I have to wait until the last second. If I do it while the shuttle is here, it makes no sense. He will not see it. Yeah? So this only works if I have, you see, from this corner, I have this shot, straight shot, from this point. Then I can change by doing this shot. If I don't have all the other four shots, doesn't make any sense. Yes. Yeah.
Oh.
It looks best from this side, I think. Yeah. Once again.